I'm sure they've got stacks of films stuck away somewhere that no one can see. It's just I don't need anyone to get the hands on it. Mondays, the way I see it, is we was really lucky. We was a lucky bunch of dickheads, because I was King Dickhead, right? And then we had Dickhead on the drums, we had Dickhead on the guitar, we had Dickhead on the bass. The first jamming session really was out of, like, it really wasn't know the truth. It was out of, like, desperation. It was out of, like, what have I done for the last God knows how many years of being in a band? So basically what's happening with the Happy Mondays now, and we're still going to record the Happy Mondays.
Right? Happy Mondays?
I'm going to go, yeah.
Not just the Mondays?
No, the Happy Mondays, right?
Oh, the Sean Ryan
band. Yeah, all the Sean Ryan band, yeah. If you ever say to me, oh, what a vocal on this X, you know, it's not my style. Bang, I will put a vocal on it. I'm very bitter about the split up of the Mondays. It's like I'm not saying anything for a while and things like that, but like I say, I wanted to keep it, right? I didn't want to fight for it because we was all friends, but I end up getting such a fucking great band around and everything, and it's lively with musicians and all that lot, that really, after wanting it for a month, now I've changed my mind, it's all it is three members of the band have left, you know, and then a lot of things get blamed on Sean Ryder and Bez, you know, we're the easiest people to blame.
Don't film this cult, someone will recognise it.
You know, you've got bands like The Cure. No, Rob Smith, you know what I mean?
Yeah, big in the
States, he's the Cure, right? But how many different members has he added in the Cure? Mm. He's not the same, you know, he's only him left, right? At least he's like me, Bez and Paul, the original members, and just because the fucking drummer, keyboard player, and the guitarist decide to leave, you know, we ain't sacking that.
Well, no, but that's in my drink,
no, that's my drink.
No, this is mine.
Voodoo for this man. I will do the voodoo that you do on Udo.
That you do so well.
And you just die there, you're out throwing darts at. Right? Here's the ex-keyboard player. He was the big important man in Happy Mondays, basically. Oh, keyboard's left. Oh, well, the deal that was on before for 1.7 million, now we're going to give you £300, just because the keyboard player's left. Now, the keyboard player didn't write the songs.
Stop.
You know, things like that. Now, I can all get very bitchy. Now, I didn't ring up the Manchester Evening News, and I didn't say, I'd rather sign on the door than work with Sean Ryder. And it's like, who split the Happy Mondays up? Drugs didn't split the Happy Mondays up, right? What split the Happy Mondays up was bitching. Three members of the band, instead of getting on with making money, wanted to,
instead of getting on with making music, wanted to make money, you know? And what have you had today? And what have you had? You know, things have always gone on since we was 15-year-old lads. And all of a sudden, it's like, what have you had? What have you done? What have you done? I'm going in, I'm going in there. All being very bitchy. What we're doing today is we're sticking everything on one tune, right? When you come back in 6 months' time, you'll say, I remember that.
Yeah.
That was off that, but it wasn't, you know what I mean? It's now on another song. And that the most important thing is, like, we can just stick some out of tune carding, right? Or something out and all play and make it sound as though that's how it's supposed to be.
Saying
it's playing, it's sounding shit.
When you're knocking the wrong note, it's bad, man.
You don't give me the eyeballs, horse. It's a jam, man. We're making a jam. It's the first time, by the way, that this band has ever played together. You know what I mean? We all know each other, and it's a jam, man. And to me, I'm there listening, and I think it sounds great. Don't do this now, man.
When
lose
you get back.
Leg in a car crash. Don't do this now, I'm going to lose both legs in a car crash.
It's already happened.
Because I'm mad.
Just one leg.
I'm really mad.
How can you kiss
someone,
man?
How the fuck can you kiss you?
Party was gone. I said it's been a great party.
still know it, hero. I mean, I wish I was. Maybe I could get to wear my underwear on my outside of my trousers.
You get treated like you're out of the fucking mafia. What for? Because you go on the stage going, nah, 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 nah. Fuck. You're a role model. Fuck. I'm nobody's role model. Bring your own fucking kids up. Be your own fucking kids' role model.
The social services come round to my house to see if I was a fit parent.
How did it turn out?
Okay, pretty good really.
You've got a pie habit.
Did they question you about your pie habit?
Pies, yeah. How many pies a day do you get through? And how much a week you spend on pies?
Stop the pies, man. I can't take the pies.
I mean, the worst thing about it is pies, when I disappear to the toilet for an hour because she knows I'm eating pies.
Everyone you meet, shit, eats and swallow. Oh, you so thick, baby, like there's no tomorrow.
You don't know no better.
You really keep going and going on the don't know no better. Don't let me do them, you do them.
I'm not going to stop, right?
All right, don't you stop doing them, because I'm going to come in with a verse.
Don't know no better. Hey, hey. Don't know no better.
Everyone you know has had you.
See, don't know no better.
What's going on? I'm pleased to be here.
Jesus was Batman.
Nah, that was Bruce Wayne, Sean.
Jesus was Batman. No, that was Bruce Wayne. That's a good lyric.
No. Jesus.
I think Jesus was the Batman.
Listening to enough Bowie.
Well, innit?
Not been listening to enough Suede.
Suede, you're a cunt. I'm going to twat you on this, you little piggy nose, you bastard student cunt from a big posh fucking family. Bet it comes from a little council. I don't care, fucking sight, yeah.
I come from the planet Zeron with my funky weapon on. My really funky radio weapon.
Look at his tucker boots.
All my tucker boots. In my jeans, I am the king of fashion, fashion.
My bisexual fashion. Bionic woman.
And there's a gnome in the garden.
But he was really my father.
I'm old man! I'm old man! Look at the breadth and width of my chest!
Okay, mate, remember last night when we swapped the word from repatriation to aggravation?
Yeah.
When I did the word aggravation.
That's so, a repatriation.
Paul, don't listen to Kermit. I'll have you stopping and turning back all the time. Just play through the track and we'll get used to it while we're going along. Dick. You ain't got one.
Don't talk to me about heroes.
Most of these men sing like subs.
Dave!
Jesus was Batman. No, that was Bruce Wayne. Don't talk to me about heroes. Let's have a listen back.
I get very paranoid, Tom, sometimes. Especially when you've done things for people. I mean, we're talking about playing gigs in 95 where we're getting 167 grand a gig, 200 grand a gig. The roadies got paid. The fucking garden gnomes got paid. The people who ate the fish suppers out of Slack's knickers got paid. I didn't get fucking paid.
Have you been inside in the Point Apple tonight?
I've had a look.
The vibe is really good in there. The place is just packed. Yeah. The women look great.
Oh, yeah, it's funny, you know, you're talking about women, right? You look at someone, we were saying, like, last night in Belfast, right? And it was, like, snowing, and you're going out in T-shirts, you know, teenagers.
It's as cold as it can get inside,
you know, in, like, with T-shirts on, and then you turn around and say, ooh, there's a nice pair of legs on there. And something would turn around, and she had milk teeth.
About third seed. Yeah, big time. Anyway, listen, I hope you're going to enjoy yourself.
So we felt like taking that.
Oh, yeah. You don't look like them.
Yeah, we're having some magic vampire. Yeah.
Good evening, and welcome to the Tomasi Party. Just slide inside and help yourself. We have a wide selection of downers.
To be back on the road, that's not happy about. I mean, to actually be back in the business, to be able to make my records and make the tunes that I like doing, and yeah, that's great. And one isn't joking here, or one isn't, like, you know, saying, oh, feel sorry for me because it's so hard. It's just how it is, you know.
When we came back, when we came, launched ourselves as Black Grape, the first, like, it was like, it was okay, right? You want to talk about drugs, we've been away for 3 years, 4 years, whatever, and you want to ask questions, ask your questions, your drug questions, get them out of the way and let's get on to something new. And then the first lot of interviews I did, it was the same old thing. I asked specifically if you want to ask me questions to do that. And then what happens on the front of the magazines, it was Shawnee's back on crack, smack and program.
Yeah.
An opportunity now to do this, I'm going to do my own thing anyway, but as far as I see it, the boys need a bit and they need someone to stand in for a while for someone, so I'll just deal with it, I'll do it.
I'm excited about the gigs. I mean, the thing is, I mean, when the album was written, there was Kermit, myself and Psycho, Carl, you know, there was three of us actually doing all the singing. What I can't understand sometimes is, like, these categories. How did you, like, coming from this other world, end up with these, like, black dudes who are, like, rappers and stuff, and, like, you know, you're, like, English white dudes. And so us, it's just about as normal as going for a fucking poo.
Why is Kermit in hospital?
You know why he's in hospital. He's in hospital because he's not well.
We got a phone call and the nurses said now that he's a horrible, nasty, bad-tempered person and he's getting better.
Exactly.
Yeah, so he never said a fucking word for the first 6 weeks.
Yeah, but what's wrong with him? Has he got a cold?
Yeah. Terrible, terrible cold.
Why don't you go and see?
Because when I got back off tour, I was fucking ill with flu, man, and we're not going into sort of isolation where I'm coughing and sneezing over someone else in the dead light.
He's very ill, isn't he?
He's very ill, yeah.
He got ill in Spain and went really ill over there, and then when he got back, he was still ill and he didn't go to the hospital.
No. Was that because he was scared people might find out what he'd been doing?
Well, he just thought he might get over it, and then he got there and he got really bad and he was losing weight and dying. His muscle took him down to the hospital and kept him there. So it was a day off death.
Yeah. What do you think's wrong with him, Lex?
I don't know. I think he's just in bad in hospital, really.
Between me and you, what's wrong with Kirby?
Yeah.
Between me and you, what's wrong with Kirby? Is Kirby's not well.
I know.
Right, so Kirby's going to get better.
So, yeah, Grope, it's a fucking wake-up call.
Yeah, wake-up call. Yeah, you love him, yeah. Sean, you talk about wake-up calls. Have you heard a wake-up call?
Me?
Yeah.
Fucking hell, I've had hundreds of them, Tom. Wake up my boots and the back of my head. It's full of jealous in the double bed. And no one knows what no one said. Welcome to the night. You can have it if you treat it right. Welcome to the night.
Boy, man.
Danny Bates, have you seen it? Yeah, Roger.
I don't want any bad vibes with the boys. Just because me and fucking Mary Jane have fell out. You saw us starting to build up on that. About a month ago. But anyway,
he was at it last night, you know what I mean? The day before, so I ain't speaking to his bitch.
Was Sean Orr just next door, was it?
Oh, no.
Well, we're not getting divorced or anything, we're just not speaking to each other and he's in a fucking spare bedroom.
Have you spoken to him yet?
No. He's staying out of his way.
I've not got this out on my mum, you know, for fashion, the air's a mess, because that's how they are.
Have a good one.
I certainly feel like your main men, your dudes in charge of the record companies, and they always need an explanation for something. Oh, it has to be some sort of gimmick. It's like, hey, why don't we get these guys wearing, like, big white coats and maybe, like, big white hats sort of thing, and
like, in the next video, we can, like, make them wear, like, small gloves and small white hats. This is a totally unique idea. When we've, like, used the same idea on the same band, three times, and this pathetic idea, which didn't work, like, 8 years before with Nelly and the Toenails, all because some prick needs a theme. Yeah, I'll tell you what happened, Strange. Kermit actually came and sung with the band.
All you have to do is sing, you've got to jump, you
can sing.
You can be
bad
doing
anything. So, anyway, what was the question? I forgot. All right, take it easy. Right. Damn, I'm so good at PR.
I love the business, but there's a lot of assholes. And like I say, most musicians are fucking plums. They're fucking plums. Luckily, I can't play a musical instrument, so I'm half a plum.
And you know football hooligans in them, right? So we're going to call it Carry On Kicking Your Fucking Head In Mix, right?
You know when you say you can't use your head, use your head. That's a real saying. Because why can't we use our head? Because nobody's shown us. Now, there's only a few that I can talk it out and tell you how we can use it, because that's my job, to see it and to say, yeah, we can use it like this. But then there's got to be somebody else there who can actually fucking turn it on, yeah. Press the buttons and make it go the right direction, and that ain't me.
Fucking awesome, man. So you've got to have an anthem bit in it as well, haven't you?
Yeah, yeah.
Now it's time, build it up, into the net. Leave that pause, man. Yeah. England's Irish! England's Irish!
Right, Loch Ness. The mud in it goes back 25,000 BC, right? Now, how we left our computer disc at the beginning of time.
We know now we've got NDA, we know we've got everything else, right? So, Loch Ness, dude starts out, he's a professor, he's everything. He starts out believing that there is a Loch Ness monster.
I got goals, yeah, I got balls, I can score.
I'll vote there. Yeah.
But scoring and balls is all drugs anyway.
Now, it goes like this, it's a thing about that big. Now, this stuff up here, it's dead thin. The mud's thin. It's like a computer disc. And it's a slightly different colour. And as it goes up, it's all dead thin, like slices, you know, fucking corned beef or a computer disc. Yeah. It's like that, right?
I should be singing. Should be singing. We got kicks. You score goals. You got your kicks in, sweet. 66, you score goals.
Because of the pollution in the air and what's already in there with the fucking microbiotic science and all that shit, they can basically bang it up. So now they can get a piece, a slate piece of soil from Loch Ness, and this slate piece of soil that looks like a computer disc, they can say, yeah, bang, that's 1522.
Macarin.
No, I need it quickly. Right, spell hooligan.
Hey, Joe.
Double O.
You watch some football movies? World Cup.
We should pick one of the teams that's actually in the Euro 96, though.
It's England.
England.
It? Yeah.
Well, shit, yeah.
To learn the future, you've got to know your past. And you've got to treat all that soil and all that lot like as individual computer discs that have been left behind for us to analyse. How the fuck the scientists have done it? I mean, we've got to trust them that they've done it in the first place.
Yeah. Anyway, I always thought of life as a big football game.
So we got to do that.
Well, what?
For this trailer, get everyone as a choir. You know what I mean? Four in the front, four at the back.
Come and have a go if you think hard enough. Got the trigger, I fire like
this. Still look like a man, don't I? Sort of like a geezer.
A geezer, yeah, definitely. I fire like this. Kilts. It'll never catch on the terraces.
Hey, I've got the best kilt. Even yours makes you all look nice.
Why do you think they're the best band in the world?
White blow number one.
That was it.
No, you gotta put them big white fucking Nelly fingers on. I've got the first best in the blend. No! Alright, you know, you're all the fucking throwing that.
Jamie, do you think complaints to me to say about what I did there on top of the pot? How do you respond?
Oh, it was amazing.
It was amazing.
Yeah, it was the dogs, but no, it was Keith Allen's bollocks.
You're the promotions director.
I was. Have you
just find nakedness on primetime television?
I thought it was fabulous.
Brother!
Come on! It's the rock and roll years and it's 2010. And they've got the proper film there when you show it, like you with your knob up and everything. So that you,
and the England players going down on the turf, hugging each other.
best, the best can release for you, prisoner. Keep the game on the pitch. Boom, G. Now it's time. Build it up. Into the net. Never give up. Cause England's Irene. England's
I couldn't give two dogs dicks about the States, really. Mike and Bernie Winters didn't make it in the States. They made it in a fucking theatre in the East End, and they still managed to live nice.
Hey man,
hey
oh,
man.
Shoes.
Are those patch of cards you're wearing?
Yeah, I said yeah, dude.
Disneyland's got him tired, you know what I mean? And he had to test a lot of shit, you know?
Anything that we've thrown down the toilet, he's been at the other end of the pipe.
Pizzas, elephant wings, cakes, a lot.
We've got to move!
Well, fuck me, everyone thinks I've got a big nose, right?
Ordinary size nose.
From that correct angle, right? Okay. Tom, give me 6 foot two.
Yeah. Robert, this is a man from Rizlas, a main dude.
To me, because I'm his mate, he's Mr. Skin.
Mr. Skin.
Mr. Skin. As far as I'm concerned, Rizlas, especially the light blue ones.
Yeah, they're the best.
Yeah, I mean, they are the best skins in the world, man. You've got what you've got to say.
You're not even poor skins, are they? It's like, everybody calls, like, a thing, you know, a vacuum cleaner, a Hoover.
Yeah,
everybody calls cigarette paper.
You get a cigarette paper, don't matter if it's called Donkey's Dick. In England, we'll still say a packet of Rizlas. Even if you only sell Donkey's Dick, we'll still ask for Rizlas.
I mean, for me in Morocco, you got to use toilet paper.
That's if you can get it. You can't spin up with a pebble. If you're a lover, music, and we call our music rock and roll, and then that's Sinatra or reggae or what, it's rock and roll, and it's done well. So I hope you enjoy it.
Listen, I wasn't there, but what I've been told, it was an accident. Do you really think this guy meant to hurt anybody?
I will speak to you there first tomorrow, and we don't want any more people at MCA. And if you do come, then don't bother coming in our dressing room. Right? And radioactive.
We're going to talk about this tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, I'm telling you now, that's our chance, right? We don't want to see any of these again.
boy. This is a comin. Oh, Danny boy.
And down the mountainside.
Any weed on the bus?
No weed on the
any weed on the bus?
Who's in charge of the band here? Anybody else back there? Is he the band leader?
He's the tour manager.
Who was smoking it when I came up?
I don't think we smoked it when you came up because we like all got on the bus with about a quarter of weed. We all made our own one skin as well. I was driving.
I mean, here's a remnants of one. You got a little roach there. I'm not going to sit here and pull everybody out of this bus, and search everybody, and tie you up for. I mean, if you got 15 people, it'd take me a couple of hours.
Yeah.
All right. What you
need to do is we can pick our weed up when we get to Rocco anyway.
You shouldn't keep it on the bus because what can happen is if I found a substantial amount, I would tow the bus. I'd impound it.
If you really check these books now, I reckon you find like 16 for like enough to get this joint about that big. And that's because one of us is idiot up their ass or something and forgot about it.
Alright,
how do we pronounce your last name,
Drew?
Okay, thanks, Drew.
New Jersey State Police.
New Jersey State Police. Alright, okay. Yeah, please.
You have a safe trip?
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Where do you go? You take care, all right? Okay. All right, okay. Fellas, yeah. Take care.
Okay, thanks, Drew.
What a nice dog.
You can do anything now, look. What's that? What? Slap him across the face and try and make it. Right, get it up there, Max.
Right, yeah.
None of you did what I said.
What?
Oh, you know, I can't believe that, you know, like, you're a fucking cocker stood here. And you've all got a nine o'clock. Oh, I know.
How did you
spot
it? Get rid of it.
Because he was on here. And there was a fucking window there that he could have locked.
No,
he didn't lock. No, he wasn't. He was stood here. There was nobody there. I checked that. I walked out. Looked, you've seen there's no one there. Come back on. I just said, sling it.
Into a tour, and believe me, I have looked better.
Yeah.
So?
Two? What are you going to go for? Five?
No, I'm not going to go for anything. How thin am I?
Getting thin.
I am thin. Hey man, you put on a lot of weight, alright? Hey, you're fucking, you know, you're losing too much weight, you look right thin cunt.
That's straight.
It's about how to look good when living on the street and deprived.
That's very James Bond there.
More 007.
Okay, yeah. Is there some white shit on your lips?
And what about one's hand?
Yeah, I think instead of like this, just very elegant. Over here, instead of to you, more elegant.
Good. Give me that James Bond look, that suave. Yeah, perfect. Hold it, again.
I got the glass stuck up my fucking nostrils.
Can we do some deal with this? No, I can make it any meal for you. I'm just got that.
Look off that way. Hold that.
Right, profile.
I mean, all you have to do is you can either one tell him I took it off you and I didn't give it you back.
That is a fucking cover, man.
Are you sure I don't look cross-eyed?
Or two, you make a report at the desk saying somebody had been in your room.
I didn't even see it. It was something to do with him.
Oh, you're at an advantage, aren't you?
Yeah, we are. Sean's good with knives. Very good with knives.
Was he going to taste a salad?
Yeah, chop you up.
I write me lyrics under the influence of a fucking Wells Cornell. It doesn't really matter. It's how one's mind is at the time. It's like, if I want to do something, I'll do it.
It's a big bopper speaking.
Whoa!
You've been out here all night and now it's morning. And I don't know if the fucker's recording, so we'll get it on film. I'm always lending monkeys to junkies. Cause I see you at the station with a bootleg in your hand. Rock the boat, don't rock your boat, baby. Rock your boat, don't tip your boat over. Fuck the boat. You can swim.
I keep striving to get higher. Gotta keep striving, we've got to get higher.
It's too high for my voice, man, I can't get there.
Wait, just trust us, when you hear this track when Danny's fuck with it.
Yeah. Yeah?
That's really good.
Does that feel okay?
Yeah.
The sound of it, I know.
Yeah.
The words aren't right, but it feels alright.
Yeah, no, it's right.
The tune. When I first met you, baby, and we were so strong, and now I feel everything is going wrong. Cause you're giant talking, telling those lies. I'm giant talking, fucking your wives.
I wanna get sick to be ill. I wanna be stoned to kill.
You gotta get sick to get high. You gotta get sick to get high. You gotta get sick to get high.
And believe me, I know, man.
I gotta get something to eat. I gotta get something to eat. I gotta buy something for my feet. I wanna get. Yeah.
His feet stink.
I gotta buy something for my feet.
He's got some old
ears.
Sean Ryder has the worst smelling feet in the world.
I wouldn't be rude when I said, look, we've got to chill it downstairs, because downstairs it's wood, we can do what the fuck we want.
Yeah, that's carpet.
You know what I mean? We got, you get in that, you get out, you've got fucking base carpets in it.
I don't give a fuck about him, you know what I mean?
Shit. What's up, lad?
Your penis.
It'll come off. Eventually.
We'll finish off with something to say. I heard the news today, old boy. 1,000 bombs in Blackpool, Lancashire. Ow, dude, when we start like ripping people's shoes off again, it's like, ow.
It don't happen like that.